Skrite is a new app that is putting AR experiences directly into the hands of the users instead of using traditional software developers. Fascinating stuff. Join us now to break it all down is Rishab Jain, the founder and CEO of Skrite. It is great to have you join us this evening.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm doing very well. Thank you for being here. Okay, so let's start right there because we have viewers who are watching right now and they say, I have no idea what Skrite is. Let's start there. Sure. What is Skrite? Tell us about the ways that you are allowing users to develop basically their own augmented reality.
Sure. So Skrite is an augmented reality skywriting platform. It actually gives the ability to the user to basically sketch, create, or upload any kind of content to the sky, and it actually gets saved at that very location where they have saved it. Not only that, whatever they're creating is actually getting created in augmented reality. At the same time, what they can also do is that they can also view the skrites which they make would stay there forever. But at the same time, they could also view the skrites all around the world and visit different skylines with virtual reality. So the phone directly gets converted actually into a virtual reality device for free. There's no headsets. There's nothing as such.
That's so cool. So if you write something in like one part of the sky and I come later and I point my phone up and I use your app, I can see whatever you wrote and you can write like secret messages for, you know, your friends?
Exactly. Exactly. So it's actually a blend of social media as well. So what it does is that, you know, you could also add your friends and families over to the application, and if they're having the same app and you make a Skrite in New York, they would be and the person's all the way in LA, but they would be able to see what you have done in New York with the whole 360 degree virtual panorama experience with your augmented reality Skrite.
That's crazy.
Wow, yeah, that is awesome.
It's also kind of romantic, you know, you're like, if you are like, right. in a long distance relationship and you're like, well, just look up in the sky and I wrote something for you.
Sure. I didn't mean to laugh, you're right, you're absolutely right. Okay, let me ask you about this, because Hope and I reported on this earlier in the week. Apple earlier in the week are kind of announcing, you probably know.
AR kit,
long time Apple analyst Gene Munster joined us for an interview, and he had basically took away from the conference and said, that's really the highlight. Forget about the HomePod. Let's talk about the AR kit, putting this power directly into the hands of users directly. So let me get your personal take on the announcement that we saw out of Apple. Do you largely see the rollout of something like that benefiting work that you want to continue to do with Skrite?
So the thing is that 2017 has been like a very big year for AR. All the major giants, they have all been targeting the AR company, like the AR experience for the next 10 years. They believe that everything would change with AR, and they are giving the ability, Apple and Facebook, they're giving the ability to its developers to develop augmented reality applications. But whereas what we have done is that we are before time, and we have given that ability just not to developers, but every individual like you and me to create Skrites on their own and express themselves. So I believe that they're doing all the work for us in terms to educate what AR is, and we are giving them the ability to make to create Skrites, to create augmented reality on their own.
So what's your goal for the app right now? Do you want to grow it internationally? Do you want to add more features? What are your plans?
So at this point of time, we had done a beta launch just like a month back, and we had a staggering amount of users. It was just without any marketing. With just word of mouth, we had around 700 users with 1,100 Skrites already made around the world. We're going to go with iOS on iOS live on this Wednesday. That's the 14th of June. You can download the app. It's called Skrite Skrite. And you can start owning pieces of the sky all over the world.
Owning pieces of the sky. I love the way you phrase that. Okay, so during this period, let me ask you this. When you roll this out to 700 users, what can you tell us about the feedback that people were giving you, specifically who tried this out? I would ask if there's anything perhaps critical or perhaps room for continuous improvement that they gave you as well.
So, we have improved a lot after that. As you could rightly see, you could see panoramas all around the world. That's something what we just added to that. We have around 1.5 million panoramas already fed in, so a user doesn't need to make these digital panoramas everywhere. He just tilts up his phone and he will see his world change. And we have seen a lot of different use cases while they were using Skrite. Some were using it to market their businesses, some were using to propose to their wives or girlfriend. But probably write something about a monument, like, you know, so you could just tilt up besides Statue of Liberty and tap on Skrite, and you would actually see when it was built, how it was built, by who it was built. So it does actually create a whole AR experience.
So how do you know when there's something that you should look for in the sky? Does the person using Skrite get a notification on their phone? Does the phone know where you are to tell you to look up?
So what we do is that we read the user's location. If he has an app, we read the user's location every now and then, and if his location is switched off, like we would probably use the cellular network to detect where he's actually there. And as soon as there's a Skrite detected nearby, he would get a notification on the phone that he would just have to tilt up, and he just tilts up, and you would see the sky change around you.
Very cool.
Rishab, here's my question. Is there any sort of filter that would be put in place? Either did you do this for the beta testing period with your 700 test subjects, or plans going forward to perhaps, I don't want to quite say police material that people could leave on Skrite in kind of public domains or even in messages, because that's not really a thing a ton of social media platforms do, but do you have the concern that people might use this for more improper things, leave inappropriate messages?
Right.
For instance, let's be completely candid. You mentioned the Statue of Liberty. What would prevent someone from going to the Statue of Liberty or pointing this up, God forbid, at the Freedom Tower here just blocks away from where we are, and kind of using the sky messages through the app to make things that may be inappropriate or sensitive to some people?
So the thing is that we have, it's a very good question. We have already worked on that, and our software algorithm, once a Skrite is pushed, in the next 5 seconds on our systems, we understand on our servers, we understand whether the Skrite is inappropriate language, whether it contains any kind of nudity or anything abusive. It would directly report to us, and it would be taken down in the next minute.
Wow.
It's that easy.
Wow.
That's a quick turnaround.
I mean, I think some other social media platforms probably...
learn from you on that. My God,
interesting model there. Tell us how you're funded. What are you doing for financing?
So at this point, the company has been bootstrapped since 1 year. We were like trying to make this a perfect app, and people could really enjoy the application. So we really targeted ourselves in making a proper product than running behind the money. So we believe that if we have a good product and the money follows. So that's our single motto. So at this point of time, our whole goal is to launch on Wednesday, get a lot of traction, and to expand in different regions and different countries. That's when we would be looking at funding as well.
And why the sky? Why not other parts of the world or landmarks? You mentioned the Statue of Liberty. I guess that's an easy one. But why the sky specifically?
I think sky is. I think sky is a monument. I think like sky is a thing which I think no one has basically monetized till date. All kinds of technology has, taken advantage of digital domains. Anything as such, even properties, but no one has treated sky as a property. What we believe is that if we actually push the sky, which everyone says that sky is the limit, but if we break that barrier, that's something what would really be a different and augmented reality experience. Like you could feel different cultures of a city. You could go to a different city. You could just tilt up your phone and you would see everything change around you.
Okay. Power of augmented reality.
That's awesome.
There, yes, and a new app called Skrite. Rishab Jain, founder and CEO of Skrite.